In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
The Lord be with you. Good morning, brothers and sisters. We offer this Mass for the eternal rest of Mary Kinmont. Before we celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us acknowledge our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ,
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. God of might, giver of every good gift, put into our hearts the love of your name, so that by deepening our sense of reverence, you may nurture in us what is good, and by your watchful care, keep safe what you have nurtured. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, thus should one regard us as servants. It's Thursday. Sorry. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, let no one deceive himself. If anyone among you considers himself wise in this age, let him become a fool so as to become wise. For the wisdom of this world is foolishness in the eyes of God. For it is written, God catches the wise in their own ruses. And again, the Lord knows the thoughts of the wise, that they are vain. So let no one boast about human beings, for everything belongs to you, Paul, or Apollos, or Cephas, or the world, or life, or death, or the present, or the future. All belong to you, and you to Christ, and Christ to God. The word of the Lord. To the Lord belongs the earth and all that fills it.
To the Lord belongs the earth and all that fills it.
The Lord's are the earth and its fullness, the world and those who dwell in it. For he founded it upon the seas and established it upon the rivers. To the Lord belongs the earth and all that fills it. Who can ascend the mountain of the Lord? Or who may stand in his holy place? He whose hands are sinless, whose heart is clean, who desires not what is vain. To the Lord belongs the earth and all that fills it. He shall receive a blessing from the Lord, a reward from God his Savior. Such is the race that seeks for him, that seeks the face of the God of Jacob. To the Lord belongs the earth and all that fills it.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Come after me, says the Lord, and I will make you fishers of men.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. While the crowd was pressing in on Jesus and listened to the word of God, he was standing by the lake of Genezareth. He saw two boats there alongside the lake. The fishermen had disembarked and were washing their nets. Getting into one of the boats, the one belonging to Simon, he asked him to put out a short distance from the shore. Then he sat down and taught the crowds from the boat. After he had finished speaking, he said to Simon, "Put out into deep water and lower your nets for a catch." Simon said in reply, "Master, we have worked hard all night and have caught nothing, but at your command, I will lower the nets." When they had done this, they caught a great number of fish, and their nets were tearing. They signaled to their partners in the other boat to come to help them. They came and filled both boats, so that the boats were in danger of sinking. When Simon Peter saw this, he fell at his knees of Jesus and said, "Depart from me, Lord, for I am a sinful man." For astonishment at the catch of fish they had made seized him, and all those with him, and likewise James and John, the sons of Zebedee, who were partners of Simon. Jesus said to Simon, "Do not be afraid. From now on you will be catching men." When they brought their boats to the shore, they left everything and followed him. The Gospel of the Lord. Sometimes when we experience the strength, the force of our own sins, of our own weaknesses, we feel like we're defeated. And we're kind of hopeless because again and again, I fall into the same sin. And in those moments, the Lord tells you, don't give up. You might say, "Lord, I have worked hard all night and have caught nothing," in the sense that I have tried and tried and tried and nothing there. And the Lord says, "Don't be afraid. Do not be afraid. Trust in me. Try it again. Try it again. Trust in my grace. You are not alone. I fight with you. I am with you." So even if you have the sensation that you are going nowhere, that you haven't achieved anything yet, sometimes you feel like you're going backward instead of going forward. Trust in the Lord. Trust in His grace. His grace is more powerful than our sins and our weaknesses. I think this is one of the lessons here in the Gospel. Don't feel hopeless. There is hope because Christ is with you. You are not alone in that fight, in that battle against your sins. The other thing is that I think this has to do a lot with evangelization, you know. The church has her own experiences, 2,000 years of experiences. That's a lot, right? In evangelization, evangelizing peoples and tribes and different cultures. The Lord is recalling us today. Don't trust in your own means. Trust in me. You know, when you know we are doing all these changes in the church, in the parish, the sound system, I hope you can understand me now. The lights, lightning of the church and everything. And you know what? One of the things I was thinking of is that all these things are good, but they are not the most important thing, in the sense that they are means to help us to evangelize and to sanctify you. So we can say, wow, but that's not going to transform us. That's not going to touch our hearts. You know, the cameras, Facebook Live, and everything, that's, oh, we're getting modern. Huh? But you know, if the mess doesn't touch your heart, if you're here and you don't go back to your house different, this doesn't make sense. So let us ask the Lord, let us reinforce this. You are the one who touches your heart, the hearts. And if I'm struggling with this or that sin, the Lord is telling you again and again, don't give up. Don't give up. Sin doesn't have the last word in your life. Let us pray in silence. Let us pray, brothers and sisters, for the church and the world. For all Christians called to become fools for Christ because they believe in the wisdom of God, that they may be faithful to the Spirit who guides them, let us pray to the Lord. For those who are wise in the ways of the world, that they may realize that the wisdom of this world is foolishness in the eyes of God, and obtain grace to see everything as the Lord does. Let us pray to the Lord. For vocations to the priesthood and religious life, that many more generous souls may have the courage to leave everything and follow Jesus, let us pray to the Lord. For all who seem to work hard through the long nights of suffering and find nothing, then in obeying Jesus they may be gladdened by a great catch of healing and grace, let us pray to the Lord. For our beloved dead, that they may belong to Christ as Christ belongs to God, in the joys of eternal happiness, let us pray to the Lord. Merciful Father, hear our petitions and grant what we ask through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May this sacred offering, O Lord, confer on us always the blessing of salvation, that what it celebrates in mystery, it may accomplish in power, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift, since our praises add nothing to your greatness, but profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread through all the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Charles our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you through all the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. We have to trust in the Lord and his grace in the midst of our weaknesses, and also when we have to do something with regard to evangelization, we have to trust in the Lord. We have to listen to him. We have to let him direct our programs, our structures. If there is no fire in us, if there is not the Spirit of the Lord within us, if there is not a zeal for his name, if there is no presence of the Lord within us, all the means are useless. We give thanks to the Lord for giving us hope, for giving us courage, for giving us the strength we need to keep going. Let us say the prayer Jesus taught to us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Renewed by this bread from the heavenly table, we beseech you, Lord, that being the food of charity, it may confirm our hearts and stir us to serve you in our neighbor, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and in the hour of our death. Amen.